You're listening to GIGI Radio, the one and only Christian radio show for teen girls, with your hosts, Esther and Steph.
Hey girls, happy Monday, it's Steph.
Hey girls, it's Esther, and we're back with another episode, and we continue with being thankful for this month.
And remember, we are changing it a bit, so the layout's different, so we mentioned last week we're going to be doing our normal episode, then we're going to do the Bible Archives, which has now its own Monday. Fantastic. and we learn more about the Bible character there. Then we have the Bible Boost from our amazing Roseanne who does this for us. And then we have our other episode as well. So it's a Dear Diary one. So it's really exciting. Mm. We're going to enjoy it. You're going to enjoy it. I think it'll be fun little...
Yeah, and let us know if you enjoy it.
Yeah.
So that we can do more of this style. But yeah, so... One thing we wanted to remind you is, and don't forget we've got that gratitude journal since we're talking about being grateful or being thankful. This is a perfect time to get it. You can go on our website, ggstorylibrary.com.au, and click on printed books and you can get your copy.
And there's a sneak peek there too, so you can have a look up, through it as well. So.
Yes, that's right. There is. And there's international and there's also Australia.
Local, yeah.
Yeah, so you can get it if you're overseas. No worries at all.
We love you and we want you to get it too.
Yes.
So we have our artist of the month, which is Dan Bremnes. Yes. I keep just think about that name. Just throws me off it. Bremnes.
Okay. And the verse was and has been, we hope girls, you have put it somewhere to remember it. 1 Thessalonians 5:18. And he says, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. And the easy to read version says, whatever happens, always be thankful. This is how God wants you to live in Christ Jesus.
Nice. It's beautiful. I love that. Now, girls, today is Bible Archives, my favorite segment.
I still
haven't figured out why, but I love it. but this one is a bit tricky because it's a group of people. So let's see if you know who they are.
Mm, okay, let's start. They were in an area between Samaria and Galilee. They saw a rabbi. They didn't get close to him. They stayed far away. They shouted to the rabbi to please have pity on them. The rabbi instructed them to go to the priests. They went to see the priests. Only one came back to the rabbi and thanked him. Do you know who it is? Who they are?
Ooh! All right, girls, have a think. Who is this group? Not sure? Okay. So let's read it in the Bible, Luke 17, and I'm reading from verse 11 to 17. Now on his way to Jerusalem, Jesus traveled along the border between Samaria and Galilee. As he was going into a village, 10 men who had leprosy met him. They stood at a distance and called out in a loud voice, Jesus, Master, have pity on us. When he saw them, he said, Go, show yourselves to the priests. And as they went, they were cleansed. One of them, when he saw he was healed, came back praising God in a loud voice. He threw himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him, and he was a Samaritan. Jesus asked, Were not all 10 cleansed? Where are the other 9? Has no one returned to give praise to God except this foreigner? Then he said to him, Rise and go, your faith has made you well.
This is such a little story, but it's so powerful.
I know.
I mean, sorry.
Sorry, you go, go.
I mean, these men, these 10 men, they were dying of leprosy. And leprosy was, and to this day, is horrendous.
The body parts, girls, fall off. Fingers, ears, pieces of their skin.
Nose.
It's bad. Yeah. And so imagine having all this restored, brand new skin, just a new person. And no one says thank you to you.
Yeah. Yeah. Have you ever experienced that before? No one says thank you when you do something?
Oh, yeah, yeah. Lots of times.
Yeah. We all have. But we can talk more after this song by Dan Bremnes, and it is Born Again.
I am tired of apathy. It's like a poison inside of me, always growing in the dark. I want the light back in me. my heart. I am tired of wandering, falling in love with lesser things. But it's time my running ends. Come remind me who I am. That's what I find when I come to you. Give me a heart that beats brand new. Give me eyes that search for you. Every day, every step till my final breath. I wanna live like I've been born again. Oh, like I've been born.
So this is really, really fickle.
Yeah.
Really. But so there's one tiny thing that makes me a little mad when I'm driving. But you know how sometimes somebody wants to get in, not like they're signaling and they're in the next lane.
Yeah.
But they want to get in front of you they're going. Yeah. And so you do. You let them go in. But they get in and then they drive off. They don't lift their hands and wave, thank you, or stick their hand out the window and say, thank you.
Esther does, guys. She does stick her hand. I mean, I do too, but I'm just saying, yeah, it is nice to, yeah.
It is nice. I know her in the car, but a little, you know, wave the rearview mirror and say, we're like, oh, that was very nice. And when they do it, the sad thing is that I'm like, wow, that was rare.
Yeah.
You know, it's something so simple, I know, but it's just, oh. But anyways. That's enough of my little fickle, what do you call
it? So, girls, if for some reason you do drive or your parents get in, say thank you to the car that let you in.
You might be Esther. But anyway, so the story today that we read about the lepers, you know, that it was a huge act.
Oh, yeah, massive.
Massive act to restore someone back to health because these lepers were going to die.
Yeah, and they were far away because it's very contagious and they were living in a village away from everyone. They
In a cave most of the time.
And, you know, they couldn't see their families or friends or anyone, the children, daughters, nothing.
Yeah.
They were living away. And now to be restored and be able to join the community and have their life back and being healed by Jesus, which for me, now thinking about it, is when Jesus heals you, that's it. There is no going back.
No.
So these men, for me, are restored for life.
Yes.
They're not going to get leprosy again.
No.
And only one came back. Mm-hmm. And it's funny because the one that came back, they said, was a Samaritan. And because Jews and Samaritans didn't get along in that time, they had to point out, where are the others?
Yes.
Only the one that's supposed to be my enemy came back to thank me,
yeah,
kind of thing.
Exactly. And we'll talk more about that further down. But in the earthly ministry, or the ministry Jesus had here on earth, was a great blessing to many people. He traveled from city to city, from village to village, and he brought healing to so many. And in those days, it was, you know, dusty roads and distances were extremely long and tiring. And Jesus and his disciples walked for many hours, and sometimes they walked for days to get to one place. So it was during this time that he was traveling from one place to another. See how he says at the beginning of the verse that he encountered this men. So when the 10 lepers saw Jesus, obviously they would have heard about who he was because he was very popular and well-known. And they had that courage and they had that hope. And they recognized that this was the Son of God and only he had the power to heal them.
Hmm.
So because it wasn't allowed, like it was forbidden for them to get close to him or to anybody that didn't have leprosy, they had to call from afar and shout to him and use their voices and ask him to please have mercy on us. You know, think of us. We know that you can do it. So just please heal us. So Jesus knew that they needed help. And immediately he said to them, go present yourself to the priests. And as they ran and they obeyed that, you know, that order, you could say, they were cleansed as they made their way.
He didn't even say you are cleansed or be clean. No. He just said, go and show yourself.
Yes.
That was.
And girls, during those times, if a doctor told you that you had leprosy, you would have to go to the high priest of the temple. The high priest of the temple will have to see your body and have a look at you and confirmed that you were a leper and you had to leave immediately, family, everything, and go to the caves. So when you were healed, you had to go back to the same high priest that saw you or a different one, and he had to proclaim that you were 100% clean and you could go back into society so that nobody could shun you anymore. So that was one thing, but
let's see what the 9 ungrateful lepers were like.
Oh, yes. Okay, so one of the things, they were ungrateful. We know that much. So the 9 lepers were Jews, and they believed that they deserved everything they could do to take advantage of the affair. So it was kind of like, no, I'm a Jew, so it's my right.
Oh, yeah. I hadn't seen it that way. Okay, let's see. They had hardened their hearts. So their hearts were full of pride. They felt no need for a savior, that also he could heal them spiritually.
So it was, he could heal their body like on top, but he could also heal their hearts.
But they only wanted the outside.
The outside, yeah. Okay, another thing, they were spiritually blind. So they did not recognize, nor did they see by faith. They were, you know, blinded, you could say, spiritually. They didn't realize that God could heal the disease, but could also heal their sins, like we were saying before. And sadly, I think we see the same thing happening today.
Yeah, for sure. Like, I think we as humans are blind and distracted with pleasures of this world, like social media, food, TV, different shows, music, you name it, cars, houses, clothes. You know, there's so many things out there that distract us that a lot of people don't even want to know Jesus because they think he's boring or they're so comfortable they don't need to reach out to anyone for help.
Right. Yeah. And the 9 lepers also did not give glory to God or thank him for his great love and for his mercy and the abundant blessings that he gave them. Because, you know, you could tell by that they didn't come back to say thank you, what kind of people they were.
And like going back to the verse, it says they said, take pity on us. And God did take pity.
He did.
You know, if you do something wrong, you want something done, and you ask your parents, your teachers, please, miss, I'm sorry, I forgot this, or mum, whatever, and they say, all right, it's okay.
Let's
You're like, oh, yes. you feel happy, relieved. They had pity on you. You're thankful. But
that's right.
These men didn't.
Okay, now let's look at the one leper. So what can we learn from this one grateful leper?
Ooh, okay. So the first thing is he was a Samaritan. So these people were hated by Jews. They were great enemies. And the Jews called them dogs.
Yeah. Yeah, they were. They were hated so much. Another thing, he showed humility. He was looking for mercy and recognized from like the depth of his heart that only the power of Jesus could do this wonderful miracle.
And he showed gratitude. So seeing that the master had healed him and saved him from certain death, he came back glorifying. He turned around from his path and came back to God, prostrating, bowing down, throwing down himself at Jesus' feet and thanking him for his healing.
Yeah, it's beautiful. He also had faith. Although he was not one of God's people, you know, he was a foreigner, he felt the need for a savior. One that would restore him physically from his death and another one that would restore him spiritually. And God, or Jesus, sorry, did both.
He did both, yeah. So, girls, you know, remember to be thankful and show gratitude for all the things you have. You might not actually see how blessed you are. We take it. This is us as well. Take it for granted. Mm. But we are, and you are blessed. Mm. You know, you have a better life than millions of people in the world out there at the moment.
Yeah. So today, at any time that you remember, say a little prayer of thanks to God. Mm. As you wander around, as you, you know, hang the clothes or whatever you're going to do.
Have lunch. Well, thanks, I've got food and a table to eat it on and a shelter to be under or something.
Yes. So that's very important for all of us to remember.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah.
All right, girls, let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for a brand new day you've given us. We are thankful because, you know, you woke us up today and you give us what we have in front of us. We ask that you bless our family, our friends, help us in the week ahead. But more than anything, open our hearts and minds to see the blessings of being grateful and to actually appreciate, Lord, what we have. Thank you, Lord, for everything. In your name, amen.
This has been GIGI Radio signing out.